Everybody, so welcome back to my channel once again. I hope you are doing well. My name is Praise. So I am going to be dyeing my hair once again, jet black. Well, that is what I'm hoping for with Amla Powder, Henna, and Indigo Powder. So as you can see, I'm using something different here, and that is the Amla Powder. I always use lemon juice to release the dye in the henna to dye my hair with. But this time around, I'm just using only water, amla powder, and henna to mix together to release the dye in the henna, all right? So I'm using about 3 tablespoons of amla powder, and then I'm going to mix it with 100 grams of henna powder. You can use more depending on the length of your hair and the thickness of your hair. So just adjust it to that. You're gonna mix everything together first before you start adding water gradually, and then mix it until it's nice, you know, and almost smooth. You know, I always try to get it as smooth as possible, but not quite get there. Anyway, so let me tell you a little bit about amla powder. When I made my other video on how to dye gray hair, I had a lot of ladies come on there and say, why not use amla powder? Amla powder is not as harsh as lemon juice. So, especially for those of you who say you experience dryness. So I said to myself, you know what? I've never tried amla powder before, even though I've used amla oil in the past. I've heard quite good things about it anyway. So I said, let me try it first before I recommend it, all right? So this is what amla powder does to your hair, all right? It says that it helps to increase the volume and shine in your hair, and it also helps to encourage hair growth, and it enhances waves and curls in your hair, and it actually also tones down the redness that you get in the henna as well. And I noticed it when I was dyeing my hair. So by the way, when I left this mixture for 24 hours, this is what I got. All right, as you can see, the dye released almost just perfectly the same way I get it released with the lemon. All right, I am also going to use gloss, and I'm also going to use some oil. In this case, I'm using whipped shea butter all around the circumference of my hair to stop the dye from, you know, dyeing my skin, literally. So this is my hair. I've already shampooed my hair. It's actually dry at the moment because I was not ready yet. So you don't have to wait for your hair to dry at all. No, you can go straight ahead and dye your hair as soon as you shampoo your hair, all right? We shampoo our hair first because we cannot shampoo our hair for at least 3 days after we dye our hair. But you can deep condition your hair after the whole process is done. And also you can go ahead and shampoo your hair and do your usual, you know, after 3 to 4 days or so. So there you go. Apply to every strand of your hair, guys, because you want this to cover your whole entire hair. All right. So I usually go like little section by section, and then I apply it like that. And when you're done, you're going to go ahead and cover your hair with a plastic cup. And then you're going to, usually I just go ahead and add a little scarf on top of that, just to avoid me rubbing it anywhere else, really. And don't forget to clean up all your little edges, you know, where anything touches the whole floor. If you're about to dye your hair, actually, see if you can put something on the floor you're going to use, all right? Because this is a dye. I know it's natural, but it's still a dye, all right? So I mixed about 150 grams of indigo powder with water, all right? And then use it immediately as soon as you finish washing the henna out of your hair. So this is what my hair looks like after I rinsed the henna out of my hair. As you can see, my hair color stayed exactly the same. When I used the lemon juice and the henna, it actually looked more browner. But this case, I guess the amla powder reduced that, all right? So I will talk about it more in my comparing the two of them together in another video, all right? So go ahead and apply your indigo to your hair just like I'm doing so, all right? And then the same thing, we're going to go ahead and we're going to cover our hair again with a plastic cap, and then we're going to leave it there for about 4 hours, 3 hours, you know. The thing is, the longer you leave it, especially if you're looking for jet black hair, the better, all right? So I left mine for about 6 hours or so. I was busy doing something else. I left it for 6 hours and this is the results, all right? Anyway, so I went ahead and deep conditioned my hair. I'm using just a banana hair mask. I'll link a video on how to make it in at the end of this video, all right? And then I applied it to my hair, my whole entire hair. Left it for about an hour or so. There you go. This is my complete result. I'm going to make a video and we're gonna compare side by side the one I did with the lemon juice and this one to see what the difference is, all right? I don't wanna make this video way too long because I just want it to be a tutorial, all right? Here we are. Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to share this video to the people that you think might need it and want it. And also, please do give this video a thumbs up if you like it. And then I will see you all in my next video. Thank you all so much for watching. And yes, I will be trying the Amla version on gray hair. So watch out for that video and subscribe for more future videos. Thanks for watching.